Humanity has accomplished so many things, from doing art in caves, going into space, to creating a living robot. We create so many things for our enjoyment, like this album called Nurture by Porter Robinson, and I swear to God, it's so good, go listen to it, please. Anyway, it seems like we're getting more and more intelligent, and IQ scores did show that we were getting smarter. But after the 1970s, however, it seems like the IQ scores are declining. So, does that mean we're getting dumber? Well, it's hard to say. Since the intelligence test was invented, we can see that the IQ scores were slowly rising, a phenomenon known as the Flynn effect, named after James Flynn. The IQ test is always set at 100 for the median population, but over time, the new generation always performed better than the old test takers. So scientists had to give harder questions to make sure that the score of the average population always sit at 100. So when the new test takers take the older test, the average score for almost all of them is significantly higher than 100. Anyway, IQ tests come with its own controversy. It is often criticized and by any means not the perfect measure of intelligence, assuming if it measures any intelligence anyway. However, since many cognitive abilities are connected, it makes sense to think that our ability to perform spatial reasoning or pattern recognition is linked to our math ability and our verbal skills. Because of this, they are thought to be a reflection of our general intelligence, and the IQ test measures those qualities. It is also good at predicting academic success, which is not a surprise since it was initially designed to do so, and how quickly you pick up skills in a new workplace. But in general, it does show some people's capacity to learn and process complex information. Non-violent criminals, on average, are smarter than violent ones, and it takes intelligence to steal without violence, and the average IQ of our country also predicts economic growth and scientific innovation. We don't know what causes the Flynn effect, but researchers think it is environmental. We are trained to think abstractly. For example, it is common to see children being taught abstract information, like what mammals and reptiles are. And in order to use technology, we have to recognize and make sense of the symbols in computers and other technologies. Other things like improved housing, better access to education, and intellectually demanding jobs are some of the potential causes for the rise. Countries that haven't undergone post-industrial development seem to support the idea since they don't show any rise in IQ because of the poor infrastructure or the lack thereof affecting their quality of life. However, this trend seems to be slowing down or even reversing. In the late 1970s, the IQ scores of the Norwegian men decreased, and other countries like Denmark, Finland, and Germany seem to be showing the same results, while countries like South Korea, Japan, and the US did not show the same kind of decline. The cause of the decline may be linked to the way we teach kids in school, from rote learning based on memorization and repetition to a more scientific problem-solving approach. This approach may encourage smarter and more effective working places, but puts less emphasis on individual skills required in IQ tests. Some suggest that the technological gap between human capabilities is increasing, making the average person less and less capable of making the best of the resources available to them. Other things like cultural changes concerning the value of knowledge and learning, the quality of teachers and the education system, nutritional choice and the way of life, and a more sedentary lifestyle may be the culprits behind the decline. Some blame the prevalence of reading going down, and some even blame the IQ test itself, saying it favors crystallized intelligence or things you learn and have been taught over time over fluid intelligence, or your ability to use logic and observational skills to solve problems. Since today's educational system puts more emphasis on fluid intelligence, it could be the cause to the decline in IQ. If this is true, it means we're just as smart as ever, just way more dependent on Google, and I think everyone wants to believe in this, right? We also value some skills over others. If we measure hunting and gathering skills in the 20th century, we probably would see a decrease since we moved away from hunting and it is just basically useless to us now. Some think nutritional standards have decreased, and some other propose that our obsession with tech is to blame. But since the decline starts during the 70s, way before we stare at screens every day, it doesn't seem quite right. Some even point fingers at immigration and smart people having fewer babies. But this is not exactly right either, since the decline is also seen within families, even siblings. So we can't blame immigration or the higher birth rates of less intelligent people. Sorry, xenophobes. And it is pretty naive to only assume genetics to influence our intelligence. Even when it influences as much as 60 to 80%, the numbers can still be deceptive. Two boys with different genetic backgrounds that are locked in a room for the first 12 years of their life without education probably would have little to no intellectual differences between them. So the consensus here is that it is environmental or maybe the IQ test itself. But does it really matter? does the rise of IQ really mean something anyway? What has the rising 30 points in IQ has given us? The presidential election of 2016? Opioid poisoning? Climate change? Even James Flynn himself argued that the test is confined to some specific reasoning skills. For instance, we don't see a rise in creative thinking over time as our IQs increased. The things causing the Flynn effect don't encourage us to think in new and original ways. Then there's rationality, the ability to make optimal decisions by weighing up evidence and discarding irrelevant information. People with high IQs are just as susceptible to the confirmation bias, the likelihood to only consider information that supports our view and ignoring those that contradict our views. Or the sunk cost bias, the tendency to throw more resources to an obviously failing project even when it would be better to cut our losses. Or temporal discounting that requires you to let go of short-term gains for long-term gains. Critical thinking also doesn't strongly correlate with IQ and does not come with higher education. So it makes sense that the rise in IQ is not accompanied by significant improvements in our society. IQ tests are also bad at measuring personality, creativity, or emotional intelligence, qualities that some people think are way more important than intelligence alone. Also, there are many types of intelligence and it can be represented only by a single number. Besides, high IQ does not correlate with financial success. Traits like discipline and talent are just as important. So, don't be afraid about the decline of our IQ. It doesn't mean we're getting dumber, just as the rising IQ doesn't mean we're getting smarter. But that is not an excuse for us to be stupid, okay? Also, go listen to Nurture, please. It is very good. Anyway, thank you. Bye.